That's how it, yeah, it's very good. I was not going to mention it. That's what I was
thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. $50.
Well, that's pretty pricey for a few pairs of petty pants.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Pinkerton, there were some extra charges. Some of your personal stakes required pounding on a rock.
Hello, Mrs. Pinkerton.
And you, Penny?
Hello, Mrs. Pinkerton. I mean, Mother.
Teenagers, they just love watching that corny college.
Delinquents. It ain't right watching dancing in the color, is it?
Well, it ain't color. Don't be silly. The TV's black and white.
For a while now, maybe we should make it official.
Oh, Link! Your council member ring? How sweet. And it matches my hair color exactly.
None of that. Save your personal lives for the camera. And we're back in 5, 4, 3.
Now, don't forget, guys and kids, our very first Prime Time Spectacular is coming up on June 6th. We'll be live at Baltimore's brand new Eventorium, broadcasting nationwide. Talent scouts from all the major record labels will be on air. And sponsoring the event will be none other than our very own Ultra Clutch Hairspray. So let's give a great big Bonnie Baltimore salute to the president of Ultra Clutch, Herman F. Spritzer.
Ultra Clutch is proud to bring you fine youngsters to national attention.
Our big break!
Also live on the special, we'll be crowning your choice on this Teenage Hairspray 1962.
My big break!
Isn't she a lovely slim girl?
I guess Amber's pretty, but she can't dance.
Yeah, plastic little spastic.
Oh no! I'm gonna kill myself! Look! She's wearing Link Larkin's council ring!
Hey, gang, don't forget to watch Mom and Me next Thursday on Mother-Daughter Day. And I want to be your Miss Teenage Hairspray. Remember, a vote for me from you is a vote for me.
What an unexpected ad-lib, Amber. And speaking of expecting the unexpected, our very own fun-loving, free-willing Brenda, will be taking a leave of absence from the show. How long will you be gone, Brenda?
9 months.
So it seems to be having an opening for a girl just as fun-loving, but maybe not quite as free-wheeling. Want to be one of the nicest kids in town? Cut school tomorrow and come down to Station WZZT to audition.
Oh my god, it's a dream of a lifetime. I have to go audition.
Oh my god, it's a dream of a lifetime. I have to go watch you audition.
That will be enough of that for one day. No one is auditioning for anything. And there'll be no cutting school in this house.
Oh, but this is terrible.
Penny, go tell your mother she wants you.
She does? Oh, I better hurry. Guys, get my bike busy.
Whoa, rush hour traffic. Hiya, ladies. You know, ever since I got that new shipment of exploding bubblegum, business is booming. How am I too funny, honey?
Oh, Wilbur, you're the funny one. Oh.
Daddy, tomorrow I'm auditioning to dance on a TV show.
No one is auditioning for anything. You're going to have to go a lot further than that to get around me. And what should I tell you about that hair? All ratted up like a teenage Jezebel.
Mother, you are so 50s. Even our first lady, Jackie B. Kennedy, rats her hair.
Yeah? Well, you ain't no first lady, are you? She's a hair hopper, that's what she is. And I got her put into detention again. Talk to her, Wilbur. Girls like Tracy, people like us, you know what I'm saying. They don't put people like us on TV except to be laughed at.
Tracy, this TV thing, you really want it?
It's my dream, Daddy.
And I say, go for it! This is America, babe. You gotta think big to be big.
Being big is not a problem, Wilbur.
You know, when I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with the circus. But I told them, no! That's what you want! I got dreams of my own! I dreamed of opening up my own chain of joke shops worldwide! All right, so I still only got the one. But someday, if I can figure out how to keep the air from leaking out of my sofa-sized whoopee cushions, I'm gonna make a noise heard around the world! You follow your dream, babe, all right? I'm gonna grab an orange crush and head back to the Hardy Hard Hut. Whoa, I already got my dream! And I love it!
You are not helping.
Thanks, Daddy.
Tracy, get back here. I have hampers of laundry and my diet pill is wearing off.
But Mom, I want to be famous.
Oh, you want to be famous? Try to get long blood out of car upholstery. Now there's a skill you can take right to the bank. You think I wanted to spend my life washing and ironing other people's clothing? No, I wanted to design them. I thought I'd be the biggest thing in brassieres. Well, be careful what you wish for. Now start folding.
I forbid you from listening to that disgusting Grace music. And the police could find your father. They'd punish you good.
Your dancing was atrocious today, Amber. I will lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crown, but you have got to work with me. Now, Lydia, that's it.
Stop! That is no way to handle clean clothes. One day you will own Edna's Occidental Laundry. Will you be ready?
I hope not.
Don't contradict me.
Don't disobey me.
Don't even think about going to that audition.
Please.
No.
Mother.
Stop.
Stop telling me what to do.
Don't
treat me like a child of two.
No.
I know that you want what's best.
Please.
But Mother, please.
Bye.
Russell.
Really? That's all? Oh, that last one was atrocious. Who would have thought that all the Baltimore girls were such scags? My, how things have gone downhill since I was crowned Miss Baltimore Grounds.
Oh, phew! I thought we'd never make it. Stupid bus crash.
All my life I imagined what this place would look like. This isn't it.
Hi there! What?
Ew.
Am I too late to audition?
Not too late, dear, just too much.
Tracy, look! It's Blink!
Blink Larkin. So near and yet so gorgeous.
I know, those girls were all over me. I don't know how Rock Hudson stands it.
Oh, I'm sorry, little darling. I hope I didn't dent your tooth.
I can be the best. Don't you hear him chime?
I don't hear anything.
Can't you hear my heartbeat? Keep me and stared. Yes, he tapped me. My heart was unprepared when he tapped me and knocked me off my feet. One little touch, now my life's complete. 'Cause when he nudged me, love put me in a fix. Yes, it hit me just like a ton of bricks. Yes, my heart burst, now I know what life's about.
I skipped school to come down here. Isn't that just too cool?
Ew.
Oh.
start over. I assure you, I'll calm down right after I have a heart attack. Oh, well, I brought my own 45, so if you put them on, I'll show you my stuff.
Haven't you already shown us enough?
Sophomore hops
Maybe he put me on a show.
Mom, if you two dance together like that in public, Donald Trump, you'll be on in the 11 o'clock.
So how do you feel about the tension now?
I'm a bad, bad girl who needs to be punished!
Come on, Tracy. Show us what you got.
Laughing, dancing at detention. Tracy turned black. You can forget all hopes of college. I'm putting you in special ed for the rest of these characters.
What? No college. Where do you go after special ed?
Shout out the White House. Hey there, sophomores. And sophomores at heart. I am honored to be your guest DJ here at PPHS. So without no further ado, let's do some dancing. It's the hottest dance around. It was born right here in Baltimore. What's it called, kids?
The Madison!
And where did you hear it first?
The Corey Collins Show!
Let's form two big strong lines. In Madison time. Go!
Baby, don't sleep. Baby, don't eat. Baby, just like to move a point.
Just give me your big chance.
Well, you better keep an eye on me.
Now when I say hit it, show me a big bad Baltimore box. Hit it!
How come we always have to get us the back?
I don't know. There's them and there's us. That's just the way it is.
Now when I say hit it, let's take it to the basket line. Breath fresh amount of air.
You got the mountain part right. Oink, oink.
Now when I say hit it, let's take a drive down Druid Hill. Hit it. Make a right. Be the monkey. He's in the back seat.
Oink, oink.
Excuse me, little darling. Haven't we met somewhere before?
Oh my God. They want to just spoke to me. Again.
Now when I say hit it, let's make it like Jackie Gleason. I'm gonna hit it.
Away we go.
Oink, oink. Hi, Corey.
Hey, cupcake. What's your name? Yeah! to you by our newest council member, Tracy Turnblad.
Oh, my word, Tracy, live in our own living room.
I think I've seen her here before.
She's gonna be a regular.
Imagine my little girl regular at last.
Hi, Tracy, it's me, Penny.
She can't hear you. Hello? Why, yes, this is her childhood home. No, I'm not her father.
So let's wave a whistle bye-bye to Brenda. See you next year. And inaugurate the newest member of our council, Tracy Turnblad. Cozy up till corny and tell us about yourself, Trace.
Well, I go to Patterson Park High, I watch your show, and I do absolutely nothing else. Oh, but one day I hope to be the first woman president of the world. Or a Rockette. You gotta think big to be big.
And if you were president, what would your first official act be?
Well, I'd make every day Negro Day.
Oh, my. I mean, you like tomorrow's headlines, Tracy. So, what do you say, kids? Looks like we might have a hot new candidate for Miss Teenage Hairspray.
No, she can't be Miss Hairspray. She's the before in a Metrical Diet ad, and I'm the after. And actors always win.
Amber, what a comedian. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
No, he can't. Because everyone knows that whenever he sings to me. He's completely involved with me, see?
Right. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
Would I? You people are ignoring the laws of nature.
Link Larkin, our own budding Elvis, will sing to the equally blooming Tracy Turnblad. His version of the top 40 hit, It Takes Two.
Mother!
Every day, that
chubby communist girl? Kissing on the mouth with possibly parted lips? I can assure you, controversy is not what Ultra Clutch wishes to promote.
Negroes and chubby girls buy hairspray too, Mr. Spritzer.
Mrs. Von Tussle, how do you plan to handle this?
Well, I plan to start by firing him.
You can't fire Corny Collins from the Corny Collins Show.
Why not? They do it all the time on Lassie. Yeah.
Mr. Spritzer, to keep up with your audience, you gotta keep up with the time.
The show is fine just the way it is.
Bringing Tracy on is just the beginning. I got great ideas for updating the show.
I'm getting one of my sick headaches. Is there some place I can lie down?
Of course, there's a bed in my office. Come on.
Oh.
So you've got ideas, do you? And going behind my back to put that chubby communist girl on the show is one of them?
Damn right, Velma. It's time we put kids on the show who look like the kids who watch the show.
Not while I'm producing it.
I was thinking it was about time to change that, too.
Are you threatening me, Collins?
You know me, Velma. On the other hand, I can always take the show to Channel 11.
Oh, my God. That snake that sings, he's a puppet, but I hold the purse and the strings. God, I knew Negro Day would bring chaos and change. Now he's pushing this pinko who might give us all mange. She's a blemish, blackhead who must be expelled. There's a standard of beauty that must be upheld. They may say I'm a bigot, but that just isn't true.
I'm sure Tracy appreciates your vote for Miss Teenage Hairspray. Oh, thank you. And she loves you too very much, whoever you are. Goodbye. Oh, this is crazy. I can't get anyone to... Hello? Oh, what am I wearing? Well, I have on a house dress, some clothes, and some scruffies. What are you wearing? Hello?
Mama, did you see me?
Of course I did. It was on television. I had to. The telephone's been ringing like we was a telephone. To think, a beloved TV icon, the fruit of my womb.
So you're not mad?
Mad? How could I be mad? You're famous. If only you had told me you were going to get on that show, I never would have said you couldn't. So tell me, is fame everything you thought it would be? Are you happy, honey?
Yes, Mama, and I think I'm in love.
I know, I've been following. But you and I are going to have a talk about crooners. We can learn a lot from the mistakes of Miss Debbie Reynolds. And there it goes again.
Hello? Yes, this is Tracy Turnblad. Hello, Mr. Pinky.
Mr. Pinky? The Mr. Pinky, as in Mr. Pinky's FG Hideaway quality clothes for quantity gals. That Mr. Pinky?
You want to hire me as your exclusive spokesgirl at Fashion Every Day? Just say that. Oh, yes, well, that's very flattering, but I'm afraid all business must go through my agent. Oh, it would be our pleasure. We'll be right over. Goodbye, Mr. Pinky.
Agent? I don't know any agents. How about a nice bail bondsman?
Mother, I'm taking my new agent down the Hefty Hideaway and then out on the town.
Who, me? I'm Tracy Turnblad. Fame has gone to your head and left you wacky. You need a top shelf professional. Who handled the Gabor sisters? Well, who didn't?
Mama, there's a great big world out there I know nothing about. When things get rough, a girl needs her mother.
Oh, hon, I'll do whatever you need to be right by your side. Together we'll claw your way to the top. But can we do it over the phone? I can let this apartment since Mamie Eisenhower's rolled her hose and robbed her bag.
Tabitha inside.
Hello, Mr. Pinky.
Oh,
hi, Trixie.
My shining star. Television doesn't do you justice.
Oh, Mr. Pinky, you certainly picked a lovely gal to put the plus in your plus sizes.
Now, Tracy, this can't be your agent. This must be your gorgeous big sister.
Oh, Mr. Pinky, you're twisting my head. I'm not a gorgeous big sister. I'm
54 double D triple E. Oh, mama, I've hit the mother load. Step inside, let's make a deal.
Hello. Sweetie, this is my
seen you before. At the gum machine getting your Wrigley's.
I do 2 packs a day.
Hmm. All that chewing must make the muscles in your mouth mighty strong.
Not me, just average.
Well, Tracy Tugboat. Looks like you found a title you could actually win. Miss Special Ed.
Amber, knock it off.
Amber Von Tussel, you have acne of the soul.
In a minute.
I'll be waiting under the bleachers.